There are a lot of data showing that health behaviors we can change, like smoking, diet, and exercise, are leading causes of death in the US and many places throughout the world. If we could motivate people to change their behavior for the better, we could have a big impact. Mass media campaigns are one powerful tool we have to encourage people to make healthier choices. And so we're trying to figure out how can we do this better. And one of the obstacles to that is that people often don't know what's going to convince them to do stuff, right? So people often don't have access, even if they want to tell us this message is going to work and this message isn't going to work. And one of the ways that we found that we can get that information is by looking in their brains. In our new study, we recruited a group of 50 smokers in Michigan. We recorded their brain activity using functional magnetic resonance imaging, or fMRI. While the participants were being scanned, we showed them a series of anti-smoking images. As they viewed the images, we recorded how much each part of their brain responded. In particular, we focused on part of the brain called the medial prefrontal cortex, which helps us integrate our rational thoughts and emotional feelings and decide how valuable something is to us personally. And our logic was that if we could increase activity within this brain region that we think is involved in computing how valuable an idea is to someone, that this would potentially predict what happened at much larger scales. In other words, it would predict how effective the anti-smoking messages were. The New York State Smokers Quit Line then used these same images in an email campaign to 800,000 smokers in New York. What we discovered was the images that caused the most activity in medial prefrontal cortex in the smokers in Michigan were also the most effective in the email campaign. This is one of the first times that we've been able to show that neural activity in this brain region in a small group of smokers is predictive of what happens at a large scale in terms of a large-scale public health campaign.